Okay, guys, we're back. This time, Carson's playing Tails. So.
He looks really awkward without all his stuff that he's going to have.
They all look awkward.
I know.
And here I thought the first game I would play for trying the channel was the Wonderful 101.
Trying to do my monitoring
adventure
and stuff. We're picking up good. Picking up good. The amount.
You know, when I played the Dreamcast version, because you can't skip the scenes ever, every time I would get to this scene, or every time I would have to play a game, I would like save Tails for last, because this scene, for whatever reason, just got me.
Yeah, that's the thing. The DX version actually changes. You can skip the cutscenes.
Because every game needs to be able to do it. Otherwise, you end up with Shadow Riku.
Curse my pollen and ragweed allergy. So.
The funny thing about Shadow Riku, they only beat that in like 2 tries.
Something like that. Also, that plane, I don't know how that plane's doing that. Also, why did Tails crash land with it instead of like when he realized it was a lost cause, jumping out and flooring himself to the ground slowly?
Great camera there, guys.
I don't know why, but I can hear the game, but the audio kind of has some static at points. Is that a problem either of you have?
Or... either your headphones are not plugged in all the way.
I've tried. Pushing it in farther.
No, I think I think what you're hearing is just, the way we're recording, I'm using a standard Elgato, which has a, conversion cable that's a standard output, but the TV footage is HDMI, which is a little bit odd, kind of looking and sounding till the video is edited, so I think what...
I didn't hear this in the last recording or any other recording before, though.
Then I don't...
Is it a plug-in all the way on the other side?
All the cords are in, Carson. Then...
Maybe it's just the game.
Mine sounds fine enough, so...
It went away, so...
Okay.
It might just be the conversion on the guitars. Weird as that sounds.
I think that's what it is.
Oh, I forgot how jacked up your acceleration is.
Well, don't forget the one thing, Carson.
Go over the one thing.
I actually don't know what you're referring to.
Sewers!
Oh, yeah.
Around...
behind the lovely couple.
No,
he remembers now. Yes. Okay.
Yeah, I've never played the game without this. I don't know how much different it is.
I've seen the Runaway Guys are
really
kind of an example.
I don't really feel a difference with
it. Have you ever played it without it?
Just now.
No. Trust me. There's a world of difference. Anyway. Kind of awkward.
I think Tails has like one of the fewest... I think he has the fewest power-ups. Main Knuckles only has 2 also.
Kind of awkward commentary about our technical things, but you know.
I think Big has the most.
As far as YouTube goes, we're kind of using a lower-end setup.
Okay, so everyone has 2 except for Sonic and Big.
Anyway.
But Carson still doesn't have the one thing that makes the one thing Tails can do pointless.
So, you know.
The one enforced power-up that I'm not sure why it's a forced power-up, except for the final boss. Well, Tails' final boss. Well.
If it is... I love the more evil-sounding Eggman.
Yeah, it's like Tails is more intimidated by Eggman.
Oh, dangerous, though.
What?
The voice actor for Eggman in this game, I think his name was Dangerous, though.
Everyone loves Mike Pollock, though.
Yes.
Which is why he's the only 4 kids voice actor that still works on the series.
Which is just a shame.
But Fun fact about Mike Pollack. Originally, when doing Sonic X, he was told to do a Dean Bristow impression, so if you rewatch the earlier episodes, he does sound more intimidating, but I think it was when recording one episode, he did the slightly more goofier voice, and they liked it, so it stuck.
And now people will get to see how you're supposed to actually fight this boss. Hey, look, a butterfly.
Mm-hmm.
It's still there, I can still see it.
Mm-hmm. So,
I love Eggman's theme in this game. And the next game.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, Carson, you have to copy my deathless run as Sonic.
That will probably
one, that wasn't deathless!
Yeah. It wasn't?
No!
I don't remember dying.
You died a lot!
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did!
Oh. When did I die?
Oh, you have to jump into it. I thought you could do the tail attack.
First of all, you fell through the game in Sonic's first stage.
I did not fall through the game. That bridge was no longer there. What happened was Sonic lost all momentum for a split second, and then the bridge went away. But that was a glitch. Other than glitches, I did not die.
Emmett, that time where you and Skydeck shot the missile at the cannon at the wrong time and died, that's not...
I totally went into the center of that cannon, you know it.
Deathless run my house.
This will probably...
As deathless as Egoraptor.
Excuse me, I did not stand still on top of a loop. That only works in Sonic 06.
But Sonic 06 is way better than this game. Sonic 06 is this game done right. This will most likely be deathless, except for possibly Tails' third level, and I don't like Tails' final boss.
But that's an amazing boss.
I
pump, 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 pump.
That's Adventure 2. I couldn't understand the boss when I was younger, so I never liked
that was
it.
Just too easy.
That does exactly.
Gotcha.
Also, if Sonic's supposed to be the fastest thing alive, why is his reaction time that of a dead goat?
Natural ridiculous speed doesn't mean you're acute to actual good reaction if you're just.
Make any sense because I thought we were supposed to assume that Sonic's living in a high speed reality.
There are things I could argue and tangent around right now, but I do not have the
so,
time.
So, what was this thing that you were talking about the chronology of all Sonic games?
I actually don't remember much about that video.
So, what was the first Sonic game?
I don't remember what the guy came
did
up
Sonic
with.
Did Sonic Unleashed take place before Sonic Adventure? Is that why we have the tomato zero?
I think he, for simplicity's sake, just started with the original Genesis Sonic the Hedgehog, and then, for the most part, assumed any game with the newer design took place some point after Adventure.
So Chaos, I just noticed Chaos 1 has only the one arm.
Yes.
It took
one
so he only has one buff arm, and his spines are a little pointier.
I've known that for years.
So Chaos 2 only has two arms then, right?
Yes.
Yes.
That's weird.
The emeralds add that ruined bone structure.
But Chaos 7 has none. Unless you're playing... Oh. Unless you're playing Generations.
Perfect Chaos!
I wish they had done that. I actually like the Generations design.
I hate it.
That's what it was supposed to look like, but the game couldn't... Dreamcast couldn't do that.
Wait, yes. What are you doing? Thank you.
On camera. Camera.
Don't turn on the free camera. That's how you get into Angel Island.
I'm not going to turn on the free camera.
That's how you do a lot of things. There's a lot of glitches.
Apparently, games have fixed cameras for a reason. This game is why I don't argue with cameras all the time. But now, Kingdom Hearts 2 has the best camera of all time. You can make that camera go anywhere.
I dread a Kingdom Hearts 2 LP.
It's coming.
I'm the one who has to do all that editing.
Why don't we have to get
You're not worried? Well, I guess Kingdom Hearts 1 Founders will be pretty easy since all you have to do is stuff out.
Kingdom Hearts 1 is...
Wouldn't we have to... First, I love playing as Tails because you can bend the game over backwards and break it.
Are you gonna actually play the stage?
Play the stage.
You already look like you're playing the stage.
You're playing the stage.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to try to do some skips like this, but...
The way is...
You're not going to do the one skip.
I can't consistently get it.
Oh, okay.
I can just do big leaps like that.
To be fair, what we're talking about, at the top of the stage, you can jump off...
Actually, anywhere in the stage, as long as you know where...
The reason I said from the top is because speedruns will jump off from the top.
Right, but you can do it anywhere from the stage.
As long as you do not fly,
too far away. But as long as you follow kind of along where the path generates, you're basically okay.
And also, you can't get too far ahead of Sonic because he does have rubber banding.
Oh yeah, I mean, it does save your time, not actually beating Sonic. Although, if you're slow, you can make it actually slower than playing the stage.
We're at the end. Speedrunners just hover their way down to this.
Yeah.
The entire stage can be loaded.
It's all loaded at once.
Look at that rubber banding. He just rubber banded right to your location.
It's proximity based. So, the way speedrunners play Tails, they just kind of jump and fly. As long as you're around the stage, the death plane won't kill you. So you can just load in enough stage. But I have seen speedrunners get a little bit ahead of the game, and I seem to remember a speedrun was shooting for the platform with the emerald, but they dropped too fast, it didn't load, so they just fell and died.
What I want to know is, why is it that... never mind, I'll bring it up when it happens.
Okay.
I love most of Tails' stages because of how much you can break them.
You know what my favorite stage is? The least breakable one.
For Tails?
Yeah, my favorite stage is one of the least breakable ones, and that's his last one. Well, this one's not too breakable, actually.
I don't like this one, because as I stated earlier, I couldn't understand the fans as a child.
But you can just... Well, it's hard, but you can just fly up. Come on,
Tails! I tried!
It's not the, ideal path.
So it's canon that Sonic sucks at pinball!
That actually goes back to the point I was about to make.
And this is one of the reasons I hate the fans.
Except that you could have avoided this.
No, I
you
stopped.
You're supposed to go closer to the wall, man.
I was trying.
You can restart if you need to.
This, like, is it might be a stage I fail at because
just
I...
Just restart.
Just...
Or wait for the fans.
Fine.
So get close to the wall, but not super close.
Oh wait, the power-up stayed used, though that's good design.
Yeah, it's what this game does.
It's kind of stupid.
It's an interesting design. I think it's so you can't, like, cheat rings.
It's so you can't cheat lives is what it is.
Oh yeah, because...
Use a life to restart, so you can't cheat lives to be
right, but
with.
You can get all those lives back. Therefore having
what,
lives
no,
to be
let
pointless.
Me explain it this way. Say there was a scenario in which there was a hidden set of two or three lives. Restarting at the cost of one and gaining two, because there are some points where there's one or two lives just lying around, and just rings in general for lives, it's... You're about to win, though. You've got this.
Well, for like one thing, you say it's kind of Sonic's bad pinball, but that would also mean that, and tell the story, the Chaos Emerald is down here. And Sonic is at the top of with the rings.
I knew Sonic the Fighters was true! There are 8 emeralds!
what about Sonic Spinball, where there are 16 and they're all blue?
Though,
I think it was they're all 16.
If we're gonna talk about Sonic things, in the classic Sonic games, the emeralds have that, like, hexagon shape, and the super emeralds are the big round ones, But the 3D games just use the big round shape, but they're smaller.
You see, it's my head canon that they're actually the Super Emeralds in all of the 3D games.
Then you should...
That's canon, isn't it?
It's...
I thought that was essentially canon.
It's technically...
I thought Hypersonic was because of the Master Emerald. In unison with the Super Emeralds.
Semantically, yeah.
Because remember, you're doing it with the Master Emerald. That's what powers them up. So I thought that's what you were... That's why you went Hypersonic. Based on names, now I'm not sure if this is true. I just assume it's actually Super Shadow. But I've heard some people call the Shadow in SA2 Hyper Shadow.
I think that was an original localization thing.
But I would assume that's not true, because that would mean he's just like, he should be overpowered, but he's the same as Sonic.
I think initially it was localized as Hyper Shadow.
As dumb as it is, if you remember... The technical reason for that and why...
Look, I'm giving you a thumbnail. Use it as a thumbnail.
Maybe. But we'll see.
You should try to, like, fly along her.
The reason for, The reason for the Super Shadow and the Hyper Shadow thing... When Shadow and Sonic transform in Adventure 2... Shadow has that one kind of muted color... And he can't do the blasting thing he can in Shadow the Hedgehog, where he has that gold color. What it's supposed to be in Shadow the Hedgehog, he got all the emerald power to himself.
Yeah, but then you're implying that Sonic would have been able to get more powerful, but he's still Super Sonic, so that still doesn't make sense.
It's a weird...
Also, it is shown in... Now, granted, depending on how canon you want to make this, they're able to share the power between him... Sonic's able to transfer the power to... it's right there. You just didn't...
You know, missed the...
The camera can be fickle sometimes.
He can transfer the powers to other people, like in Heroes, but when he did it to Shadow and Silver, they actually went into their super forms.
Heroes, Sonic's just being an ass!
Or Tails and Knuckles can't absorb it.
Which is bullshit,
actually, they can. It's probably the same thing for them, except for the Flicky's
death. I'm just going to assume Heroes was done for the sake of balance, because someone made a fan game, Sonic...
Anyone want to talk about Hyper Knuckles?
Oh, I'm getting to that. A fan game, it was Sonic 2 and 3, but every character was active at the same time, like in Sonic Heroes.
I saw that.
So you had Hypersonic, Hyper Knuckles, and Hyper Tails all at
the same time. You could have Hypersonic with the Flickies of Death.
Basically. And whatever the hell Knuckles does.
I actually know what Hyper Knuckles does, and it's the most pointless thing ever, and you probably never noticed it, or if you did, you wondered why did that happen.
You mean the earthquakes as a street nuke?
Yes. That's what Hyper Knuckles does. But to trigger it, you have to fly a certain amount of distance and slam into a wall.
Right, no, I knew that's what it did. I just never found a practical use for it. Not like Sonic's that just has to press A twice for screen nuke.
Sonic, if you press A jump button twice, no matter what jump button you're using, he does a dash.
Oh, come
but
on.
The dash, you can dash left, right, up, and even down. The screen flashes and everything on screen that isn't a boss dies. You're invincible and you can breathe underwater. Super Sonic cannot breathe underwater.
I might actually lose this.
I believe.
I thought all the hyper forms could breathe underwater.
Except Tails is just Super Tails. Tails doesn't get a natural hyper...
What are you doing? You didn't take the shortcut.
Oh, damn it.
Oh well. He didn't see no...
You've got decimated.
But he keeps getting ahead of me.
It's because of Rubber Band. This is the hardest stage to get a heap ahead of Sonic. Because you're not, flying and breaking it.
And I keep also mistiming the jump ramps if I can...
It's hard.
You've got it.
Take it. And that... Taking that Blizzetta style shortcut. Yeah, if you look a little to the left, you see Link racing Blizzetta.
Well, and Yeti Sex.
Wait for Twilight Princess.
Wow, that game's gonna be amazing.
And that's also my joke.
That's probably gonna be a part name of Twilight Princess. Well, and Yeti Sex. We all know what happens.
I still think it's funny that, like, there's gonna be, like, we're all gonna play different Zelda games. It's the only series we're splitting up, as far as I know.
Can't I?
Very likely.
Can't I
because
get the next upgrade now?
You two, you two haven't played Ocarina of Time as much as me, and I love that game. Sean has a freakish hard-on for Twilight Princess.
I know, it's played it as much as I have.
And Carson had a freakish hard-on for Wind Waker, even though I remember it better than he does.
I did the photo quest.
Oh no.
With a guide while I was reading it to you. The photo quest is just...
The only question, who's playing Majora's Mask?
If...
And a link to the past. Probably me.
If we could record a DS game, I would, well, 3DS games, I would do Majora's Mask.
I thought you liked them both equally.
I don't mind Majora. Okay, here's the...
No, I'm just wondering, I'm not wondering, like, because we don't like it. I'm just wondering who's gonna do it.
It might end up...
I can't for once.
Yeah, why are you jumping?
It might end up being me, but the thing is...
The jump is awkward because of his flying.
In order to do Majora's Mask...
You know his tails do damage, right?
That's what I was doing.
In order to do Majora's Mask, I should probably download the Virtual Console version. I am not using that GameCube disc.
Oh, that makes sense.
For people who don't...
There's also, now probably end up playing Link to the Past.
For people who don't know, there's a collector's GameCube disc that has Ocarina of Time, Majora's Mask, the original Zelda,
and Zelda
2. But because of the way the game is... I'm not picking the audio.
No, but you're picking up my audio. Hold my ears.
Sorry if I'm a little loud here, but I have the audio recording at such a minus amount of decibels, I don't really peak it.
Okay, so, just continue. I'm just letting you know I'm hurting my ears.
Sorry. This is the volume I've been talking in all the LPs, because I naturally talk kind of loud,
okay.
So, anyway.
Go on. Oh wait, well, let me bring up a point here. This was the point I was going to bring up a second ago. So, in everyone's story, they all fight, or Tails, Knuckles, and Sonic, they fight Chaos 4. I can only assume what actually happens, is supposed to be happening, is that they all three fought Chaos 4.
That's how Sonic X does it.
That they all three fought it?
Yeah.
But, and I'm assuming that the game, you know, obviously for game logic, just Tails fights it. And I'm assuming from perspective, it's just showing you they're part of the fight.
And also,
Sonic X.
That's one thing I like about Sonic X. When it gets these parts, it clarifies some weird oddities.
And this Sonic X also
this is the easiest version of this boss.
Battle take place.
So those hitboxes active when flying.
Only on certain parts of the body.
To finish my Majora's Mask short point.
I can just rant.
That GameCube disc, and this is why I don't want to record Majora's Mask with that GameCube disc. Majora's Mask on that GameCube disc is known for prolonged playtime. The game crashes. Because the game crashes...
That's why you never got all the heart pieces in that version.
It's too hard to play the game, especially for an LP. Because Majora's Mask, especially because of how the original saves...
You know, people complain about this boss being too long, and I'm almost having it under
You're
a
playing
minute.
Tails. Tails has the lowest health bar.
He does?
I believe so. I know Sonic is the longest. Knuckles might be the same.
I believe Tails has a hit or two shorter than Sonic than
Why?
Knuckles.
Because Sonic's like the main game, and Tails is like a part of it. Also, something I will correct myself on. Jumping around like a maniac on Sonic is not how you're supposed to fight this boss, make him pop up earlier. It's standing in one place for longer.
Because I...
And that's why it works faster for Tails, partly. And he doesn't do that one time with the bubbles like he did with me. Is because Tails can stay off of the platform, but he can't...
See, I got that in under a minute and a half, so...
So, for Majora's Mask, I would need the Virtual Console version because it's more stable. That GameCube rendition is nice, but it's too prone to crashing. I would need to download a Virtual Console version just to record. And a Wii U or like potential NX Virtual Console version might have a better suspended point system. I don't mind save scumming a few trickier heart pieces.
Yeah, group play around.
Yep.
Who wants to play Zelda 1?
Not me.
So I hear Carson's playing Zelda 1.
No.
I hear Carson's playing
if
Zelda 2.
If anything, it should probably be me.
Yeah, you can probably play Zelda 1.
If I do that, you have to do a full playthrough of Bumpity Track.
Obviously Carson is not playing Zelda 1.
I can save time and heartache. I have Zelda 1 committed to...
So who's playing Castlevania 2?
Memory, at least well enough.
Carson, you're playing Simon's Curse, right?
Well, it's Simon's Quest.
Don't know when we should play Ocarina of Time.
What'd I say?
You said Simon's Curse.
What?
No.
He called Castlevania 2 Simon's Curse.
It's
well,
Simon's
actually,
Quest.
I guess Simon's Curse isn't that too far.
What a horrible night to have a curse.
Oh, also, God! Just to... Oh, never mind. Bring it up later.
When do you get...
Yeah, I'm not sure if we're actually going to play... You're going to go to the tomato one.
I was going to ask, when do you get Tails' next upgrade?
Do not show me the lake where...
Oh, you can't not get his upgrade.
Don't show me the lake where you fought Chaos. I'm going to have flashbacks to Nom.
What, did the runaway guys get trapped in there?
They wasted hours in there.
Anyway,
for anyone...
the tomato one.
It... Something Sonic Adventure does, there's hidden chow eggs just in the overworld.
Yeah,
there's...
if you press that switch. I was about to say, Carson, if you press that switch, you get another chow egg.
I know.
The runaway guy spent hours fucking with that thing.
That was the part of... I had watched the... that part of the book.
Interesting thing about the music in this game... Other than the instrumental character themes, Tails is the only character whose theme is sung by the opposite gender of himself. Sonic's theme sung by a man, Amy's theme sung by a woman.
And now
that's a really random fact.
And
oh, wait, hold on. I will correct you. Gamma has no gender, and therefore the opposite of no gender is a
I said
gender.
Except for the...
So unless you can find...
I said except for the instrumental themes.
Oh, Emo 2 doesn't have a voice actor. Oh my gosh, it works! It is sang by a robot!
It wouldn't technically, if you think about it, music is just
Knuckles' theme
singing.
Is also a guy... Ah, the Knuckles rap.
We'll get to it.
I know, it's great.
Yeah, so anyway, I don't know if we're going to actually play the original Castlevania games. Now the Metroidvania games.
Especially because I would have a lot to say during Super Metroid.
I was referring to, Sutton. Symphony of the Night.
Yeah, I know.
Ah, Symphony of the Night. That's a glorious, glorious
Zelda game. 1, while it's like...
Oh, it's... damn it, there goes my pure platinum.
Zelda 1's aged horribly, but because of how kind of horrible Zelda 1 is, I have a lot of it committed to memory.
And 3D Castlevania Carson.
I know Zelda 1 well enough where before even touching the first dungeon, we'll have like 6 hearts and the white sword.
I will admit, doing this again in Tails' stage, it does come off as padding.
What?
The Disaster Burner minigame.
Except that it happens in both stories.
But you...
It wouldn't make sense not to be here.
Just skip
okay.
it.
No.
So there's a level of padding that still makes sense.
Sonic have this one,
no.
And Tails gets the second one.
But that wouldn't make sense.
There's another reason that they did this.
Why?
As dumb as this might sound...
Is this to load them on the egg carrier?
No. You're talking as if someone played the entirety of Sonic?
Ah, true.
That too. You can stop Sonic as soon as you get Tails as a playable character.
True. But...
Who could you have played this as?
True.
I would agree with you if it was... Even looking at it that way, that's like saying every time you play a stage is like padding.
Gameplay of the stages is different enough.
Except it's the same stage. With Knuckles, I might agree with you because you're roaming the stage with a different objective. But Tails is the exact
Tails has same. Those fly rings, but that isn't.
And yeah,
Tails
but, is but only... most of his stage. Oh, okay, Ice Cap. Yeah. How is that different than this?
Tails is only one.
Oh, I wanted to talk about this scene. This is supposed to be a flashback of how Tails and Sonic met, but the problem, they were too lazy to come up with an original area.
So now it's just the jungle.
No, you mean they probably didn't have enough time or, like, disk space?
They're just using the Mystic Ruins jungle.
I mean, it's smart.
They probably couldn't have designed a new area. Remember, this game has four vocal tracks.
It was initially a Dreamcast game.
This must have been just before the time, even though I'm sure this part of the fandom exists. But this must have been just before the time that, you know, people ship because of these kinds of scenes.
People always ship.
I mean,
the Adventures of Sonic the Hedgehog, which people call it.
Also, look at that night
backdrop. Is that supposed to be night, or did the skybox forget to load?
Yes.
Good shot there,
also, this is where you can get big. As Tails.
Holy Hotels, crotch for a minute. This might be a thumbnail.
Oh, there is a skybox there.
It's just... Sonic. Someone's crotch might be a thumbnail.
Well, there goes the monetization.
I've said fuck in so many videos, I'm not getting monetization as it is because you can't curse because Mr. YouTube will look at, talking about cussing made me think of something. Someone, I don't know if it was real, it looked real, they found this old, like, newspaper from the 1900s, and this newspaper from the 1900s was giving an example of what-
I don't remember which way you go.
Okay, call.
Let me say this, because you two are going to laugh. This was from the 1900s, which is why I'm not sure how real it is, but it was an example of in the 1900s.
By the word.
Train station.
It was a newspaper from the 1900s giving an example of in the 1900s of it was what was...
See? This is a good way to do this. Using an optional thing, it can tell you what to do. Just sticking you in the jungle and saying, you have to be here, not letting you turn backwards.
Anyway, so this newspaper from the 1900s was talking about, women being improper, and the example of improper women, it was women fighting, and one of the women, I will claw your eyes out, bitch. That was from the 1900s, and someone
they
said...
They weren't playing around back then.
And then someone said, are you sure this is the 1900s? This sounds like women now.
They weren't playing there.
Hey, Froggy! Hey,
I actually forgot, because of Tails' limited estate number, they force him into this minigame.
Should we talk about Chris Thorndike?
I actually like this minigame.
Switch on top.
Yeah, I remember.
Which you can get up here as Sonic.
I tried.
Don't remind me.
I tried for hours when
I
was young.
Don't remind me.
I got up there.
Goddamn.
Also,
the runaway guy.
You also can get on top of the temple as Sonic. I should have showed that off.
I've done that as Sonic, though.
But I've heard people swear that it is physically impossible.
I swear I did.
I don't know why people say it's impossible.
I love this music.
I don't know why people say it's impossible to get anywhere, because as I have seen people prove, you can as Sonic. Get places that even Tails and Knuckles probably couldn't get
and
to.
Because this area...
You don't want to talk about Dreamcast piracy? Because that's topical.
Right now?
Sonic Adventure! That's a perfect time
now
to...
Now I can get it out of the...
Oh, you're not going for score then.
This is not Sonic 06, but... And because of the
Not that he needs the score!
First,
you know.
Before you bring up the... Dreamcast.
You can't lose this!
You can.
What?
You can get so stuck that you can't move.
Yeah. I mean traditionally.
Because of the way that this is set up, I wonder...
It's not like if he gets to the end and doesn't have a good score, he loses. Which would have been arbitrary.
Wait, is this Sand Oasis?
It's supposed to be.
I was going to... No, it's Desert Hill.
No.
That was the name of the sub-game.
It's supposed to be the desert from, again, Angel Island. Which goes back to that point where I was harping on the runaway guy's brain scratch. And so many people...
Well...
Like, I respect those channels.
Well, I've heard people say that, in Spyro, you don't... Oh, look, Sonic the Hedgehog was added to the list. So, anyone who doesn't know, you can play Game Gear games in this game, and for about every 20 or so emblems, you unlock one.
And by Game Gear games, you mean Sonic Triple Trouble and nothing else.
Oh, because of Game Gear, I learned something. Japan was the only country that got Sonic Drift. America didn't get Sonic Drift. America just got Sonic Drift 2.
They didn't change
but when
name.
It was released in America, it was called Sonic Drift 2.
And because
that confused people.
Well, that was a mini game. That's the only.
Okay, go get the rhythm badge.
Yep, this is where you get it.
Yeah, I remember.
You cannot continue the game without getting it.
I remember where
also,
it is now.
Who else has spent hours exploring this place?
What I was going to say.
Did they not?
Oh! I just remembered something else the runaway guys did here.
Did they faff about here for hours?
The Knuckles party!
Where was the...
Oh, sweet Jesus! The Knuckles party!
Where was the badge? I don't...
They stood! The runaway guys stood in the street! The Echidna tribe
it's,
that
well,
was...
It's on one of those weird ground rings.
It's like over...
But I don't know the exact direction it's in. You don't want to stay too high, though.
Oh.
It's on like this middle
area. It's right here.
Rhythm badge.
Now Tails' model looks complete.
You spin me right round, baby, right round, baby, like a record, baby. To do continuous tail attacks,
hold the action button down. I was going to say because that one.
Spin it. This is the perfect time for a joke of tail spin.
Because first, this is now how I'm going to traverse everywhere.
What? I didn't know you could do that.
This is your thumbnail. Make it your thumbnail. I didn't say this.
I'm leaving this in.
Can you move around like that?
No.
I'm leaving this in.
I didn't say this game was perfect.
Hey, for once, guys, we can say we are recording instead of damn, I wish we were recording.
Yeah.
We're recording.
I just want to see if he'll stop or if he'll go through the floor.
Why aren't you traversing like that anymore?
To be fair to that, yes, while that was a glitch, the game didn't break. Now, where was I supposed to go?
You have to leave.
No.
Oh, wait.
It's Dr. Tikal. Who is somewhere around this temple.
I thought she was
She's in this section. She's standing by stairs.
I didn't.
But she's only standing there once you get this.
Go
power.
About towards the.
This is the only
exit.
This is the only power up that exists in this
there,
area.
Yeah.
And you have to get it as. You have to get it before the game lets you continue because there's no way back here.
As I was going to say, that the one desert.
I wish there had been a stage related to this area and you could come back and forth.
The one Desert Hill sub game is, besides the flying, the only sub game that's not connected to. A level, and the flying one was at least progression-based. That's just there, so I wonder if they originally had a desert-themed stage that had to be cut.
Better they couldn't figure out how to get Tails here.
As I said, with the glitches, I never said the game had it aged. It did age, but to be fair, it was a glitch like that. A, I actually wasn't trying to break the game, unlike Egoraptor, and B, it just looked funny. The game did not crash. I didn't somehow die in this overworld sequence, so it's not that bad.
I'm not even sure what happened if you did die in this overworld area.
I don't believe it's possible to die.
I think you can. Oh, the game kind of has a little safety thing where predetermined loading points.
Well, because you can.
Also, Tails has impaled that frog.
Well,
Big's theme, also sung by a man.
You mean a frog?
Again, John St. John.
Yeah.
This is Duke Nukem.
Yes.
Which in later years, people asked him to do the Big voice again, and he said. He hated Big so much, he forgot how to do the voice, and he can never do it again. He cannot ever make this voice again. He has mentally blocked himself. He hated Big.
I like how Kyle just kind of blows it off like, oh, okay. Good thing I extracted this from the stomach of the frog.
To be fair, Tails is a two-tailed fox. If he questioned a giant purple cat walking around